गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, इमर्जिंग ट्रेंड्स एंड चैलेंजेस इन क्वेश्चन डॉक्यूमेंट एग्जामिनेशन, इट इज ऑलवेज अ बर्निंग टॉपिक, इट विल नेवर बी कंप्लीट, इट इज एन ऑन गोइंग एक्सरसाइज। फ्रेंड्स, एज यू ऑल नो, डॉक्यूमेंट्स आर एविडेंस ऑफ अवर कंप्लायंस विद सोसाइटीज रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड द टर्म्स एंड कंडीशंस ऑफ इंटरेक्शन विद अवर क्लाइंट्स, customers and neighbors. They are the record of past actions and future intentions, the message bearers of our civilization, and as personifying as a fingerprint or as anonymous as a grain of sand. Question document examination is an interesting field of forensic science that has a direct application in administration of criminal justice. It has a long history and a bright future. Friends, forensic document examination deals with the physical evidence, and physical evidence cannot lie. Only its interpretation can err, and only the failure to find it or the disinclination to hear its true testimony can deprive it of its value. This is the quote by none else than Huber, who is the author of the book Handwriting Identification, Facts and Fundamentals. Friends, another great expert, Ordway Hilton of his times, has stated as far back as in 1969, it's fortunate that while liberally bestowing new writing and copying devices, science and technology has also presented the document examiner who is laboring to keep pace with them with some new tools. Now, let me first say what constitutes an emerging trend. Friends, emerging trend is a natural tendency arising out of introduction of new technology, a new concept or idea that could mature and develop into a critical mainstream issue in future or become a major trend in its own right. Following the emerging trends, setting up new trends and meeting challenges thereto is an ongoing natural phenomenon. Experience shows that in the present scenario, every case becomes a research problem in itself and consequently requires a new approach to problem solving. Friends, electronic technology has taken over much of the functions of handwriting in the business world. Penmanship is no longer seriously taught nor taken as a principal goal for the aspiring student. Madam Hedy Harrelson had yesterday discuss such subject in detail, the decline of physical handwriting. So friends, change is the law of nature. Everything, including the document materials and modus operandi of fraud, changes with the passage of time. Hence, mindset and approach of the expert too needs to be redefined or fine-tuned to meet the resultant challenge. Now I come to the emerging trends in document forgeries. This is based upon the papers published during the last 5-6 years in Problems of Forensic Sciences Journal, to which I had also contributed a few papers. The first among that was transposition forgery through image processing. Friends, the arrival of plain paper copiers and digital image processing have added new dimensions to the nature and modus operandi of white collar crimes based on the cut and paste techniques, transposition, etc. This study presents an actual case wherein computer-based digital image acquisition technology coupled with photocopying has been used as a tool both for the commission of fraud as well as for its detection. Now the next case which was reported in the journal was regarding the digitally manipulated machine generated document. In the present case study, the question document comprising a poorly reproduced photocopy was submitted for examination to ascertain its genuineness or otherwise. For the purpose of comparison with the question photocopy, investigation produced an original record copy of the same, which was obviously showing different contents. Using the method of superimposition, the suspicious contents of the question photocopy were matched with their corresponding portions taken from the original source document, both manually and electronically. The inconsistencies revealed by the superimposition clearly indicated that the question photocopy was a tailor-made document that was digitally produced by the usual cut and paste method, manipulating the contents of the pre-existing original document. Now I come to the next case, that is regarding inked signature forgery having digital origin. This study presents an actual case of signature forgery wherein digital technology was used for the acquisition and transposition of a genuine signature onto a stolen bank check, followed by inking of the electronically produced guideline corresponding to the transposed genuine signatures. The guidelines that was found was in the presence of colored dots due to the laser printing, color printing. The next case is regarding forensic examination of digitally fabricated hybrid signatures. As a byproduct of technological advancement, the digital fabrication of signatures is made easier by computer-based image editing tools and modern reproduction techniques. The present experimental study was conducted to find out the symptoms of forgery in digitally fabricated hybrid signature synthesized from multiple signatures of the same person to induce a sense of variation in the resultant signature that is normally not present in traced forgeries. Some of the imperfections of forgery which could be observed in such signatures are the alignment defect, background traces, irregularity in shape and density of halftone pattern, disturbance in uniformity and consistency of letters, variation in letter spacing, over deposition of ink or toner particles at places, shifting in location of dots, and evidence of overlapping in adjacent strokes. The detection and analysis of such like features could be helpful to detect a fabricated signature of this type. Coming to the next experimental study, it was regarding the electronic signatures which were captured through touch devices like mobile phones and digital tabs. Friends, as a consequence of technological changes in production of writing and signatures, it's but natural that the corresponding modus operandi of producing forged writing or signature also changes. This has obviously brought new challenges for the document examiners. In the present study, a comparative study of electronically captured signatures vis-a-vis the conventional pen paper signatures was made to find out the resultant effect of change in writing media on the handwriting features. Interestingly, it was observed that despite apparent differences in mode of production and appearance of both the types of signatures produced by the same author, it is still possible to establish their authorship because handwriting acquisition and production is primarily a function of one's neurology. However, due to the physical changes or pictorial appearances in the signatures produced on touch devices, it's not that easy to fix the authorship. Lot of experimentation needs to be done in this regard before actually implementing it in practice. Then coming to the more than 10-year-old problem of clone checks, this is still an emerging trend because the problem has not yet been resolved. The challenge thrown by encashment of cloned bank checks continues unabated for the last several years. According to investigators, what is the modus operandi of such fraud? Usual was checks are stolen from drop boxes, they are color scanned, and then with the help of sophisticated computer software, all the details on the check except the signature were erased. Since the forgers happened to be master forgers, a variety of routinely used check papers were available at their disposal, which gave them the liberty of having the approximate paper quality and color. And according to a victim, the collusion of insiders looked imminent because the account which was not touched had little in it, while that had enough money was siphoned away. It's clear that the gang would have checked the balance before deciding which account to withdraw from. Just see the smartness of this gang. Usually a PAN card and ID proof was essential for cash withdrawal of over 50,000 rupees. They just restricted the withdrawal to 48,000 rupees to evade that condition, even though the clone check amount was rupees 90,000. Now coming to the today's presentation. This presentation is based upon the Interpol review of 2020, covering the papers published and presented in various forums during the last 3 years. The topics which are normally chosen for Interpol review were handwriting comparison, ink composition, inkjet and laser print analysis, crossing line sequence, analysis of paper, indented impressions, altered documents, and security documents. Further, I have also scrutinized some of the papers that were presented in Wrocław Symposium of last year, which I too attended for that. And the topics that were covered in this symposium also included all the important aspects of question document examination. Now coming to the review, first, it is regarding the instrumentation and working methods. An overview of the instrumentation and working methods used in the question document laboratories around the world demonstrated that it is relatively constant. This survey could be useful for laboratories to consider new instrumentation or examination methods. Next, coming to the writing inks, several studies have been published concerning the analysis and discrimination of writing inks with several kinds of writing instruments. The results of these studies could be found useful by the document examiners to improve the existing methodology of forensic examination in day-to-day problems that are being referred to them. Then regarding the methods development and improvement, as you all know, TLC is one of the oldest methods available to a document examiner, and it is still studied and used by forensic laboratories. Further, Raman spectry is a useful non-destructive method to identify dyes and some other components in inks, which requires no sample preparation as such. Hence, it's increasing use in forensic labs. And some authors discriminated several ballpoint pen inks by ATR and FTIR and HPTLC. It was reported that the discriminating power of ATR, FTIR was 97.93% by visual examination, which was enhanced to 99.69% using the chemometric analysis, while that of the HPTLC was 93.8%. Now coming to the much talked about topic about chemometrics, which is the recent trend. It is basically the application of mathematical or statistical methods to chemical measurements to enhance the discriminating power of the area of interest, compounds of interest. And multivariate data analysis or chemometrics are one of the most studied field of research concerning pen inks. A chemometric approach is primarily used to classify samples or to discriminate them. The use of a chemometric approach increases the discrimination power of analytical methods. However, there's a caution, intra-variability of the samples is rarely presented in the chemometric results. And due to this reason, chemometrics should be used as a tool to help in the decision making process, but obviously it cannot replace an expert in the field. Now coming to the printer and printing inks category, the black inkjet inks and toner analysis is a current challenge for examiners, and some researches were published on this topic. As many as 9 papers were published on printer identification, and they are all based not on chemical analysis, but on physical features with sometimes the use of deep learning system. This type of research is still in its beginning stage, and some parameters that could influence the results were not discussed in the work. Some authors analyzed an identification scheme using the halftone texture of color laser image prints as an intrinsic signature. The results showed that halftone textures were dependent on driver settings and hence could be manipulated. Now, coming to the problem regarding dating of documents, for many years now, this topic has been one of the most important challenges, either in absolute dating, especially in ink dating, or in relative dating by the determination of writing sequence. Then ink dating remains a challenge task for forensic document examiner. Despite several studies that have already been published, it remains controversial, especially regarding the reliability and repeatability of results. In addition, the document storage conditions remain a hugely influencing factor in the methods currently in use. Several analytical approaches may be employed, such as solvent evaporation or dye degradation. The most studied method is the analysis by gas chromatography and mass spectra of phenoxyethanol component of ballpoint inks. Then another important aspect was the papered analysis and paper dating. So some authors analyzed papers for characterization and discrimination by FTIR. They applied further chemometrics to enhance the discrimination and interestingly achieved a discriminating power of around 99%. Some more authors analyzed and compared papers by FTIR and chemometrics. They found that paper sheets originating from different producers or from various production technology units could be differentiated. Some more authors determined the authenticity of or counterfeiting of banknotes and Brazilian driver licenses by video spectral comparator and atomic force microscopy using roughness and topographic profiles of the calcographic region. The usefulness of the AFM analysis could be discussed as the observations by video spectral comparator gave the same conclusions. Some more authors analyzed revenue stamps by energy dispersive X-ray fluorescence coupled with chemometric tools to discriminate between authentic and counterfeit stamps. The authors proposed this method for use by non-specialist operators to screen for the counterfeit stamps. Now, coming to relative dating and line sequencing, it remains a challenging task for forensic document examiner despite several studies published. As demonstrated by the review of some authors, the difficulties of this task are also being highlighted by a wide range of methods that were used for testing, such as microscopy, AFM, hyperspectral imaging, Raman spectroscopy, etc. All the researches focused on the determination of sequence of heterogeneous line intersections, and they determined that results were mostly positive, but it was usually under some specified conditions, hence their restricted application in casework. Some reviews presented the usefulness of AFM in different fields of the forensic science, including document examination and cross lines analysis. Another important application, 3D application of confocal microscope, was explored by some authors to determine the sequence of homogeneous line intersections produced using black or ballpoint, black or blue ballpoint, fountain pen or gel pen inks. The authors were able to determine correctly the sequence in about 81% of the cases. Now coming to altered documents, some authors examined documents altered by software. The examination procedure that was usually performed on physical documents was extended to be used on digital documents as well. Several defects like inconsistent spacing between letters or words, discrepancies in size, font or design, crowding of various letters and words, non-uniformities in the background revealed the alteration in test samples. Some authors proposed a new method to detect forgery in a text by detecting different ink using image processing instead of conventional methods. Some more authors applied a wide field time resolved luminescence method with a pulsed laser and a gated intensified CCD for deciphering obliterated documents. Now coming to other developments, few studies focus on the topic of forensic intelligence, even if it is an important field of investigation for the fraud analysis to link cases or to reveal some trends. Some authors postulated that a monitoring approach rooted in the systematic examination and profiling of counterfeit and forged documents using forensic science methods shall provide novel, relevant, and useful crime intelligence. They have developed a method to compare the characteristics of false identity documents. Some more authors also highlighted the importance to extract information of counterfeit documents to generate forensic intelligence for sharing on an international platform. Then coming to the core topic of handwriting and signature identification, wide variety of research has been reported, starting from the study of some new parameters of handwriting identification, introduction of statistics into the handwriting identification methodology to enhance its objectivity, to the determination of pen pressure in handwriting using 3D confocal microscopy. Some authors compared the results of determination of authorship from a homogeneous group of writers by document examiners and laypersons. Interestingly, the laypersons too determined authorship with average accuracy scores of 76%, whereas the percentage was more than 98% for the forensic document examiners. And still it could be said that for a proper analysis, the trained forensic document examiners must be chosen over the laypersons for examination. Then some authors wrote a book review for the second edition of Huber and Heydrich and brought out certain new features that were produced in this book. Then some authors studied the effect of age and Parkinsonism on handwriting characteristics. Several variations in such handwriting were observed, which made them look different altogether as compared to their corresponding normal writing. Another author determined a correlation between texts by using a relative width and height of handwritten letters. And some more authors studied the variation of the signatures over an average of 4 decades. The authors, based on 8 characteristics that they have defined, determined that the variation of the signature was very little over time in the case and characteristic that were subjected to the study. Of course, it cannot be generalized for most of the writers as a routine case. Then the results of the study of Caligari M revealed that several kinematic handwriting features were significantly associated with accurate FDE opinions for writer identification. The study of these parameters could be used by examiners with classical parameter to determine if a signature is genuine or simulated. Then coming to automatic systems, some authors extracted some features used by forensic document examiners and applied statistical tools to create a classification of writers leading to their identification. However, some parts of their research are not commensurate with the FDE's perspective. Some authors tested different new features that improved the automatic writer identification. And another authors studied the potential of human interventions to improve automatic signature verification and concluded that improvement was obtained when human interventions at feature extraction level are done manually annotating signature attributes. Then another author presented a new semi-automatic signature labeling interface inspired by forensic document examiners. Then there are several limitations of automation process. Lot of independent research has focused on computer-based recognition and identification of handwriting without the actual involvement of document experts. That is why we are finding it difficult to apply this research in the actual case study. Some of the fundamental concepts of handwriting production and identification, which are taken care of by the experts during manual examination, are compromised by the automated systems. For example, extent and range of natural variations, which are essential ingredients of natural handwriting of a person over a period of time, cannot be accounted for in such systems, thereby leading to incomplete or erroneous results. Hence, automated machine systems have a limited role in forensic handwriting identification. They can only assist the examiners to the extent possible, but obviously cannot replace the human experts as such. Now, there are several human factors that affect the results. The expert working group for human factors in handwriting examination was constituted by the National Institute for Standards and Technology. They have since released their reports in February 2020 and made far-reaching recommendations for the forensic document examiners, which are still being processed by most of the labs. Now, coming to the cognitive bias and statistical approach, Lewis discussed on the cognitive bias in document examination and recommendations to minimize them, but the document examiner should not work completely blind to information. That is what he has suggested. Some information is definitely required by the examiners. Handling cognitive bias should form a part of the syllabus for training of the examiners. And another examiners studied the occurrence of predetermined characteristics found in handwriting and handprinted samples, while Vastrick T measured the occurrence of handwritten numeral characteristics. And some interesting miscellaneous research trends have also been noted in the survey. In an interesting study, the authors studied the 3D depth measurement of the grooves and measures of the relative pressure variation along a graphic pattern by a laser microprofilometer. For any given writing means, that is pens, and writing medium, that is inks, the authors defined the intra-variability and inter-variability in degree of indentation. In another interesting study related to COVID-19 crisis, some authors drew parallels between the current COVID-19 crisis and the apparent forensic science crisis. It investigates if the shared approaches of the problems and the solutions thereto could emerge. It is concluded that forensic science's best assurance to address current and future challenges, particularly in an area of digital environment, remains a sound scientific approach, including critical thinking and interdisciplinary observations, which is nonetheless very important for the examiners. Then some papers were reported regarding the influence of paper density on the threshold of recovery of indented impressions, and efforts were also made by some authors to reconstruct shredded documents, which is important for investigation, but it is time consuming and requires a lot of patience. Then let me summarize all these emerging trends in various groups. Then coming to chemometrics, according to published study, the use of chemometrics can increase the discriminating power of techniques already in use in our labs. Studies on this topic should be encouraged, but without compromising some basic principle of research, such as the study of the intra-variability or the determination of the limits of the method. Chemometrics should be used as a tool to help in the decision process, but obviously it cannot replace an expert in the field. Then coming to the use of new technologies in document analysis, the trends concerning document analysis are the use of new technologies to analyze inks and papers and use of chemometrics to evaluate the analytical data. Researches are heading towards the development of new methods which are more sensitive, but these methods may be destructive, time consuming, expensive, and sometimes not very useful for the forensic scientists. Therefore, the challenge remains that forensic scientist is not only a chemist, the results must be evaluated from a forensic point of view. Forensic information must be helpful for investigators and courts of justice. Now, regarding the handwriting and signature analysis, the researchers on handwriting comparison have been focused on the use of automated and statistical tools. The fact that these works are still in process is the proof that the implementation of such devices is very challenging. Furthermore, extent and range of natural variation and symptoms of disguised handwriting are not taken into account by these systems, despite its crucial importance in the field. Hence, despite being useful to some extent, such automated systems cannot replace the human experts, because ultimately it is the opinion of the expert which matters in the court of law, notwithstanding the introduction of new methodology or technology in the process. Then, regarding the automated systems for document examination, they are based on the research and the analysis of similarities, only similarities between the handwriting, whereas an expert analyzes and compares both differences and similarities. The researches on handwriting comparison have been focused on the use of automated and statistical tools. The fact that these works are still in process is a proof that the implementation of such devices is very challenging. Further, disguised handwriting is not taken into account by these systems, despite its crucial importance in the field. And regarding document fraud, two trends seem to exist: forensic intelligence and the use of automated systems. Forensic intelligence seems to be a good way to identify connections between cases at national and international levels, in addition to criminal intelligence. And forensic intelligence takes the subject of forensics one step further and describes how well to use the evidence recovered at crime scenes for extended analysis and the discrimination of new forensic intelligence. Then the major challenges for document examiners, first and foremost should reside in the improvement of the evaluation of the results obtained from methods that are already developed and used in our laboratories, backed with strong researches and databases. And data analysis, the implementation or development of database for the identification or the estimation of the occurrence of a characteristic in a population would help the forensic scientist in his mission. And friends, any tool used by an expert must be mastered by them to the point that they should be able to explain their basic principles and how they work. The blind use of statistical tools, which we do not know fully, should not be encouraged. And the dating remains a challenge for the forensic scientist. A consensus between different labs seems to have reached and standardization has begun. However, ink dating must remain a research topic, especially regarding the reliability and repeatability of results. Methods based on non-destructive examination should be preferred and encouraged for obvious reasons. Friends, here is a list of the references which could be referred if someone is interested to go further. And then challenges are beautiful opportunities in disguise. Those must be grabbed. And goodbye, friends. In the end, trends are to be set and challenges are to be met. Thanks for the patient hearing.